Blessings and welcome to the Lutheran Church of the Good Shepherd on this first Sunday of January 2021. 2020 is over. Let God's people say, Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Oh, it's been quite the year for all of us. I hope you're all safe. I hope you all had a good Christmas. This is also the second Sunday of the Christmas season. This is a tag team service. I am Glenn Kneller, a lay pastor here at Good Shepherd, and doing our gospel and our sermon will be Pastor David Glau. He's also a member of our congregation, and he will be doing the sermon from his home in the comfort of his surroundings and safely isolated from the rest of us here that we are also spread out. There, I really wanted to do a children's message, but I had the idea that the new year should be brought in with a bang, and I couldn't find the canon that I made in high school, so we'll work on that a little later on for some other thing that might be fun for the kids. So let us focus our hearts and minds to the reason why we are here, to worship our Lord. And we begin with confession and forgiveness. We begin our service in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen. Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name. Through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Dear friends in Christ, God is steadfast in love and infinite in mercy. He welcomes sinners and invites them to his table. Let us confess our sins, confident in God's forgiveness. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you in thought, word, and deed, by what we have done and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your holy name. Amen. Almighty God, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in eternal life. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Amen. Our gathering hymn, number 302, As With Gladness.
As with gladness.
the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
With you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God, our Redeemer, you created light that we might live, and you illumined our world with your beloved Son. By your Spirit, comfort us in all darkness, and turn us toward the light of Jesus Christ our Savior, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen. The first lesson is from Jeremiah 31, 7 to 14. For thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. See, I am going to bring them from the land of the north, and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labor, together, a great company, they shall return here. With weeping they shall come, and with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk by brooks of water, in a straight path in which they shall not stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my firstborn. Hear the word of the Lord, O nations, and declare it in the coastlands far away. Say, he who scattered Israel will gather him and will keep him as a shepherd, a flock. For the Lord has ransomed Jacob and has redeemed him from hands too strong for him. They shall come and sing aloud on the height of Zion, and they shall be radiant over the goodness of the Lord, over the grain, the wine, and the oil, and over the young flock and the herd. Their life shall become like a watered garden, and they shall never languish apart. Then shall the young women rejoice in the dance, and the young men and the old shall be merry. I will turn their mourning into joy. I will comfort them and give them gladness for sorrow. I will give the priests their fill of fatness, and my people shall be satisfied with my bounty, says the Lord. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Psalm 147, starting at verse 12, is spoken responsively. Praise the Lord, O Jerusalem. Praise your God, O Zion.
For he strengthens the bars of your gates. He blesses your children within you.
He grants peace within your borders. He fills you with the finest of wheat.
He sends out his command to the earth. His word runs swiftly.
He gives snow like wool. He scatters frost like ashes.
He hurls down hail like crusts. Who can stand before his cold?
He sends out his word and melts them. He makes the wind blow and the waters flow.
He declares his word to Jacob, his statutes and ordinances to Israel.
He has not dealt thus with any other nation. They do not know his ordinances. Praise the Lord. The second lesson is from Ephesians chapter 1. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in Christ with every spiritual blessing in the heavenly places, just as he chose us in Christ before the foundation of the world to be holy and blameless before him in love. He destined us for adoption as his children through Jesus Christ, according to the good pleasure of his will, to the praise of his glorious grace that he freely bestowed on us in the Beloved. In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of our trespasses according to the riches of his grace that he lavished on us. With all wisdom and insight, he has made known to us the mystery of his will, according to his good pleasure that he set forth in Christ, as a plan for the fullness of time, to gather up all things in him, things in heaven and things on earth. In Christ we have also obtained an inheritance, having been destined according to the purpose of him who accomplishes all things according to his counsel and will, so that we, who were the first to set our hope on Christ, might live for the praise of his glory. In him you also, when you had heard the word of truth, the gospel of your salvation, and had believed in him, were marked with the seal of the promised Holy Spirit. This is the pledge of our inheritance toward redemption as God's own people, to the praise of his glory. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The gospel reading for the second Sunday after Christmas. The gospel according to St. John, beginning with the first verse. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God. All things came into being through him, and without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and that life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. He came as a witness to testify to the light, so that all might believe in through him. He himself was not the light, but he came to testify to the light. The true light, which enlightens everyone, was coming into the world. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world knew him not. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who receive him, who believe in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood or of the will of the flesh, but of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us. And we have seen his glory, the glory as of the Father's Son, the Father's only Son, full of grace and truth. John testified to him and cried out, "This was he of whom I said, 'He who comes after me ranks ahead of me, because he was before me.' From his fullness, we have all received the grace upon grace. The law indeed was given through Moses. Grace and truth came through Jesus Christ. No one has ever seen God. It is God the only the Son who is close to the Father's heart, who has made him known. This is the gospel of our Lord. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, let us pray. Heavenly Father, we give you thanks for all the love you have given us, and the graciousness and the joy that comes at this season. We celebrate the birth of Christ, your gift to us for all time. Not the way we would want to celebrate this year, not the way we should we would like to celebrate, and we have in the past. But we celebrate still and share the joy, the love, and the gift that you have given. Through the Holy Spirit we pray. Amen. Today, being the second Sunday after Christmas, falls on what we would normally call the ninth day of Christmas, since there are only 12 days of the Christmas season. These are times when Christmas does not seem to be Christmas for us, doesn't have the joy, didn't have the expectation of Christmas Eve services and children's programs and parties and caroling. The light seems to be dim on this Christmas day due to our world, which is under the curse of the COVID-19 virus. But the ability to show love, to feel the joy and still celebrate the gift you have given us, is still with us. But as children of a loving God, we can find ways. My wife and I were the only two at home for Christmas dinner. One point we didn't know if we should even make the full dinner. But then we were talking and it came about that there were only two of us at home, but we exported four other meals, so other people became happy, celebrated, had a Christmas meal that they wouldn't have had. A way of sharing, and a way of us getting rid of some turkey so we have it for a few extra days, not a few extra months. we look at that, and that can happen. And we can do that all along, not just at Christmas time. But there are ways in which we can still share the love of God and show his love for us. Three of the four Gospels start with events around the birth of Jesus. They do so in different ways and with different emphases. Matthew starts and talks more about Joseph than Mary. And Matthew talks to the people of Israel and emphasizes their history and the connection of King David and how Christ is the fulfillment of their history and part of who they are. Mark doesn't mention it at all. He starts with the baptism of Jesus and his story of God's great love. Luke, he starts very early, but he begins and he wants to make sure that we know that Jesus was historically present. He was a real person, not a character, not a myth, not someone that we can't say wasn't here. He places him all through his gospel in the time that they were living. But he also remembers that it was a fulfillment of God's promise after so many years that was indeed for the people of God, to bring love and help to all. John focuses on not only the time of Christ's coming, and not only the promise fulfillment, but John focuses on the fact that Jesus, as the Son of God, was the Word of creation. That he was pre-existent with the Father. This wasn't some new dreamed-up plan. It's no God dot two. This was God's living plan for us all along. His love for us expressed in his Word of creation, and a Word which now came to us as Jesus Christ. He also emphasizes the humanity of Jesus. Not like the Greco-Roman legends and gods who supposedly would seduce, rape, or trick others into performing so that they could have a child. But the child never equaled the father. The child was, at best, a demigod, like Hercules, having some powers, but not really being a god. However, Jesus was. He came as God to live among us so that we could feel, he could know, and we would know that he knew and experienced our lives. When he was in his ministry, he experienced the illnesses that were around, many of them almost at an epidemic or pandemic seriousness within the country. Leprosy, pushed aside, their people hidden from every place else and forbidden to come near unless they were clean. Others with other diseases. He healed them. He touched them. He brought them wholeness and life. And so Jesus comes to us in this time as we celebrate his birth, being his children, being the one who came with love and hope and redemption for us, so that we might know of his presence. We might know that God has been planning and bringing him and his love for us here. After hundreds of years, Jesus was born after the promise. But he came and fulfilled that promise. And now we know by that very act of Christ coming in love, in joy, and bringing hope, that God is with us thousands of years after Jesus' birth, in a time which we haven't as a people witnessed in a long time, in a time that is more dangerous than the pandemic of 100 years ago of the Spanish flu. Yes, we've overcome some diseases through the science God has given us to study, by inoculating people on a very, very rapid and strong program. Smallpox has basically been eliminated from the world's curses. Polio has been brought down. Tuberculosis, if we follow what needs to be followed, can be healed, where before, once again, people were just put away because that was best for them and for society. They were put in places like in Fort Capel, retreats that were where they were sitting in their rooms and on the porches together, but not able to go out because of the good health. Now, we have come to depend on the science that cured smallpox, And we have come to think that it's almost automatic. But it took, 70 years before a flu shot was developed? And even then, because of the virus and the way it changes from year to year, the flu shot must be repeated. It's helpful, it's good, but we have to do what is necessary to keep it that way. And so with COVID, we're getting there, but it's going to take a while yet. And the wearing of masks, the not having the celebrations that we want, that we would love to enjoy, not having family home, well, they're our act of love too. Because we're not just protecting ourselves, we're helping to protect others. And God has told us, and Luther explained to us in the fifth commandment, you shall not kill, that it means that we should do nothing that would harm our neighbor, and we should do everything that we can to help our neighbor, to protect our neighbors, and to give them the love God has for them. And so these are our ways of doing this. It's not easy. Well, I was in the hospital in August, and I had to wear the mask, and I panicked a few times when they were trying to put me in those small tubes of the MRIs and the CAT scans. But I understand why we do that. And I got there, and I got back to it. It's not always easy for everyone else. You come here, you'd like to see the face. You'd like to see the smiles and the laughter. But for their protection and for yours, it's God's will that we do that. It's His will that we share the love that He has given us. It is His will that we indeed proclaim His love by doing acts of kindness to all sorts of people in all places, that we turn to help them and love them, care for them in any way that we can. In some, that means staying away because we do jobs, or staying away from the people we love because we do jobs or tasks which put us at risk. For others, it's knowing that we don't know whether we're at risk or not. We may be asymptomatic, but that doesn't mean we don't protect other people. Yes, God has come to us and brought us in this time of season a way to spread joy and love and kindness, a way in which we normally wouldn't do or think about, but somewhat we normally do, because we all have always shared Christmas cookies and baking with others. We exchange gifts to show our love. And this is just one way that we give the gift of God. John wanted us to know that God continues to love us, that in this time and in this place, in a world filled with fear, God is still here. God is loving and caring. And as we celebrate Christmas, as we celebrated Christmas, and we still have a few days left to celebrate Christmas, we do so knowing that which we do to protect others is our gift to them, as Jesus was God's gift to us to protect us from death and from sin. This is not God's punishment. This is the fact that our world has been corrupt by sin. A simple virus, a simple little organism that suddenly becomes virulent and comes towards us. But He's also given us those who are working to overcome, those who are working to help those who are sick, those who are working to help stop the virus through cures or vaccines. So we continue to give thanks to God for his love, for his mercy. And in this season where we celebrate Christmas, where we celebrate his love, his joy, we can still share in many ways, in ways that we may not have thought of. And we can continue that sharing because God has given us love and strength, and he will give us the hope we need to continue in the path of love. We can face our fear, but we do so with caution. We don't do it by being macho and going out and daring it to attack us. We do it by being loving and caring and helping others to not catch and not be exposed to the virus itself. God gave us the gift of love in the birth of a child in Bethlehem 2,000 years ago. And now he gives this world the gift of love through his people, the reminder of the gift of Christ. As we celebrate Christmas in any way we can, and we celebrate with joy that he has given us his love, and he enables us to share that love with others. In his name, amen.
We will now gather together in proclaiming the Nicene Creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all that is seen and unseen. We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, was incarnate of the Holy Spirit and the Virgin Mary, and became truly human. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried. On the third day, he rose again in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is worshipped and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. We believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. Joining our voices with the songs of the angels, let us pray for the church, the world, and all those in need, responding to "Hear us, O God," with "Your mercy is great." Redeeming God, you gather together your people from the farthest parts of the earth. Protect your church from stumbling. Let it not be overcome by sorrow, division, or despair. Make us radiant with goodness, that we might live always to the praise of your glory. Hear us, O God. Your mercy is great. You bring together heaven and earth. All creation testifies to your splendor. Hold the ecosystems of this earth in delicate balance, from coastlands to farmlands, forests to wetlands, deserts to rainforests. Show us new ways to live in harmony with the world around us. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. You overflow with grace upon grace. Expand the imaginations of those who serve in positions of authority. Open their hearts to the needs of their nations and communities. Protect all those in harm's way and those risking danger for the sake of others. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. You bring consolation to those who weep. Embrace those who feel far away, excluded, or defeated. Accompany those living with chronic and invisible illness. Sustain the weak and weary. Refresh those who labor under the weight of pain or sickness, especially those that we hold in our hearts. And we present them to you. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. You come to us in the beauty of darkness and of light. Bring justice and reconciliation to communities divided by oppressions and misuse of power. Guide us to speak holy words of advocacy and truth. Help us to honor your image in one another. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. You turn our mourning into joy. We give thanks for those who have died in faith. With all the saints, give us our inheritance in Christ, in the fullness of time. Gather us all together in your mercy. Hear us, O God, your mercy is great. God of mercy, come quickly to us with grace upon grace. As we lift these and all our prayers to you, in the name of Jesus. Amen. At this time, we would normally take the offering. We just want to thank you for your gifts through this time of COVID. You can continue to give through regular mail, automated deposit, or by e-transfer, so that the work of Good Shepherd may continue. Thank you. The offertory prayer. Gracious God, you come to us as one unknown, bringing joy and salvation to the earth. Nourish us at your banquet table, that with all who welcome your birth, we may proclaim your peace, revealed in Jesus Christ, our Savior. Amen. Because there is no communion in this service, we will now do the thanksgiving for the word. Let us pray. Praise and thanks to you, Holy God, for by your word you made all things. You spoke light into darkness, called forth beauty from chaos, and brought life into being. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. By your word you called your people Israel to tell of your wonderful gifts. Freedom from captivity, water on the desert journey, a pathway home from exile, wisdom for life with you. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Through Jesus, your word made flesh, you speak to us and call us to witness. Forgiveness through the cross, life to those entombed by death, the way of your self-giving love. For your word of life, O God, we give you thanks and praise. Send your spirit of truth, O God. Rekindle your gifts within us. Renew our faith, increase our hope, and deepen our love. For the sake of a world in need, faithful to your word, O God, draw near to all who call on you. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, to whom, with you and the Holy Spirit, be honor and glory forever.
Amen. Amen.
Gathered into one in the Holy Spirit, let us pray as Jesus taught us. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins as we forgive those who sin against us. Save us from the time of trial and deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Now may Almighty God, who sent the Holy Spirit to Mary, proclaim joy through the angels, sent shepherds with good news, and led the Magi by a star, bless you this day through the Word made flesh.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you for tuning into this service. As far as we know, for the foreseen future, we will continue with these recorded services. Check out the church Facebook page, YouTube, or contact the church office if you have any requirements, or just to keep updated on what's happening with our services. Thank you. And now our sending song Number 300, the first Noel.
When you are.
Share the gifts of Jesus.
Thanks be to God.